Students, let's we'll see the graphs, how we are applying the graphical representation in kinematics. So let's see here. First of all, we'll take the graph of displacement and the time graph. Displacement time graph. So in different conditions, what about the displacement and time graph? So first, I'm considering the particle or the body at rest. When the body is at rest, what about the displacement versus the time? So see here, displacement generally we are considering on y-axis, time on x-axis. What is the meaning of rest? The position of the particle does not change with changing time. Time is going to change, but position is remains constant. First second, position, same position, third second, same position, fourth second, same position, fifth second, position remains constant. That means what we are getting? Straight line parallel to the x-axis. This is the graph. When your body is at rest condition. Next, when your body is moving with uniform velocity. Uniform motion. That means here acceleration of the particle is zero. Then displacement is equal to acceleration zero. And the value of the displacement ut plus half a t square, and that is goes to simply ut. U is constant here. This is look like y is equal to mx. Where m is slope, or u is means what is the graph you are getting? Straight line passing through the origin. When the particle starts from origin. Here, if you want to find the value of velocity, then you can take simply this is the velocity, you can take slope as. So then this is s and this is t. So you can take here m is equal to u. When which is starts, not starts from origin, which is starts from somewhere else, from 5 meters, then C value positive. When which is starts in the negative, C value negative. Like that we can take uniform velocity. Next, third one, uniform acceleration. Take starts from rest and uniform acceleration. If u is equal to 0, no problem. If u not equal to 0, also not a problem. U is equal to 0, then you can get s is equal to half a t square. Means this is look like y is equal to ax square, parabolic graph. Where a is a positive. We are taking uniform acceleration. A is positive. Positive means you will get the graph increasing. A is increasing. Velocity increasing. So then you can get increasing graph. This one. Displacement versus a time. When initial velocity is zero. And then s is equal to half gt square, half a t square. Then y is equal to ax square, where a is positive. If uniform retardation. And then what we are getting? Retardation is nothing but taken as negative acceleration. Here u may not becomes zero. So then here what we can take s is equal to ut minus half gt square. Here also not compulsion u is zero. Not compulsory u becomes zero. So ut minus half a t square means this is look like y is equal to ax minus bx square, where this is b is nothing but acceleration negative. So that's why you are getting the decreasing graph. What we are getting? Decreasing graph. This This is represent decreasing condition. Displacement versus time. Displacement versus time graph. We have four conditions here. First one, uniform, I mean rest condition, straight line. Uniform velocity, straight line passing through the origin, and uniform acceleration, this, and uniform retardation, this. Next, velocity versus time graph. Velocity versus time graph. So here again, if you are considering body at rest, rest means, so graph is empty or we are not able to represent anything. Velocity versus time graph. Next, moving with uniform velocity. Uniform velocity means constant velocity. Uniform velocity means constant velocity. And the velocity is constant. So, V constant. And time is going. Time is goes on, increases. Velocity constant. So, here sometimes they may ask how much displacement which traveled. Displacement traveled by the body is equal simply area of the graph. Area of the graph. Area of the graph. Simply this is area of the graph. If you are giving O, A, B, C. So the area of the rectangle O, A, B, C. Rectangle. Area of the graph. Area of the rectangle. Area of the rectangle. But next, uniform acceleration. What is that? Uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration means increasing velocity. So here different conditions are there. So let's see here. Uniform acceleration, and particle is going with the velocity time graph, initial velocity u, if you are considering. Then the graph will be goes to like this. Means how it is. V is equal to AT plus U. Means Y is equal to MX plus C. This is actually U here. And this represent A. A. V upon T. That represents A. U is initial velocity if you are considering. If U is 0. If U is 0. If initial velocity 0, then V is equal to GT. It's look like Y is equal to MX. Only Y is equal to MX. Y is MX, then straight line passing through the origin. Straight line passing through the origin. If V is equal to U minus GT or U minus AT, means nothing but negative. That's only we are named as retardation. Then what we are getting it? Uniform retardation. Uniform retardation. If it is uniform retardation, nah, then you are getting the graph better to take here. Uniform retardation. Uniform retardation. So then V is equal to, you may get U minus AT. V is equal to U minus AT. Nothing but V is equal to minus AT plus U. Y is equal to minus MX plus C. Means M value greater than 90. M value greater than 90 means the slope value means you are getting like this. This is the value of U. So like that we may get the graph of velocity and time. Velocity time. Here rest, no graph. Uniform velocity, which can cover somewhere. And here what about the area means if they are asking about the displacement. If they are asking about the displacement, then you can take displacement is simply area of the triangle. Whatever. What is the shape? If it is triangle, then triangle. If it is rectangle, then rectangle. So whatever, we can able to get it easily. Uniform, acceleration versus time. First, if you are taking uniform velocity. Uniform velocity means no graph. Because acceleration 0 here. Acceleration versus time. Next, uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration. we can able to take uniform acceleration, means constant acceleration. If it is positive acceleration, then you can take like this. Negative acceleration, uniform retardation, means you have to take in opposite case. Uniform retardation. Uniform retardation. Uniform retardation means negative A. Whenever it is negative A, so then you can get T value as negative. Uniform acceleration, uniform retardation. Non-uniform acceleration. Non-uniform acceleration, actually no need to take here, whatever the condition, that's it. Here in case if they are asking about velocity, then the velocity is equal to here, area of the graph. Velocity here, area of the graph. Here also, area of the graph. Velocity is nothing but area of the graph we can take. And non-uniform acceleration, non-uniform. Non-uniform is increasing acceleration if you are taking, increasing acceleration. So then you can able to represent like this. Increasing, constant increasing acceleration. Constant decreasing acceleration, you can able to take in opposite case. Increasing acceleration, increasing acceleration. This is for uniform acceleration. Nothing but positive acceleration. That's why in positive. This is nothing but negative acceleration. So that's why in negative. And this is uniform. Uniform acceleration. And let's continuously only. We'll see here. For a vertically projected body, what about the displacement time graph, velocity time graph, and acceleration time graph for vertically projected body. For vertically projected body. For vertically projected body. So first of all, you have to know some basic principles of vertically projected body. Up to the maximum height, its velocity decreases. Up to the maximum height, its velocity decreases. Means acceleration negative and velocity in the decreasing order. From maximum height to ground, velocity increases. Nothing but G value plus. G value plus means in both cases acceleration is uniform. The first case decreasing velocity, next case increasing velocity. So then take first displacement versus time. Displacement versus a time graph, if you are seeing that. So we are projecting it from the ground. So now first of all, what is happening? Decreasing acceleration means negative acceleration, decreasing velocity. Nothing but decreasing graph you are getting. Next, increasing velocity, then you are getting the increasing graph. So this is the up to the maximum height. Let's see here. We have maximum height here. This is H max, maximum height, displacement, time. This is a time of ascent, U by G. And this is a time of descent, U by G. Time of ascent, time of descent. Total time is equal to time of light. Total displacement. We are projecting from origin and again which reaches the origin. We are projecting from the origin, from the ground, again which reaches the ground. This is displacement time graph for vertically projected body. Vertically projected body. Next, velocity time graph. Velocity time graph. So what happened to the velocity? Initially the velocity is decreases. Initial velocity up to the maximum height. Can you give the equation of up to the maximum height? V is equal to u minus at or u minus gt up to the maximum height. Means slope in negative condition. At maximum height what happened? The velocity becomes zero. The velocity means it is initially u value. Initially u value. And which is starts to decrease at the maximum height on x-axis y is equal to 0. On x-axis y is equal to 0. And then in opposite side velocity increases. Opposite direction means generally we may think like this. But the, what is the meaning of that? We are projecting the body. After reaching of maximum height, that is taking some rest. And again going upward. Up. If you are taking like this, that is the meaning. Now here what happened? We are taking the vertically projected from the ground, we are projecting, which reaches the maximum height. At maximum height, final velocity is zero. And again, the velocity increases in opposite direction. Velocity increases in opposite direction like this. So here if you are taking the displacement, again it is pluses, it is minus, the total value will becomes zero. Same condition, displacement. That is a velocity versus time graph for vertically projected body. This is u by g, time of ascent. This is u by g, time of descent. Time of ascent, time of descent. Next, acceleration time graph. Acceleration and time graph. Acceleration time graph, if you are seeing that, so up to the maximum height, what about the acceleration? Negative but constant. From maximum height to ground, positive but constant. So this is acceleration versus time graph. This is minus g and this is plus g. Acceleration on y axis if you are considering. And this is a time of ascent. This is time of descent. Time of ascent and as well as time of descent. So like that you are getting the graph for vertically projected body in case of displacement time, in case of velocity time, in case of acceleration time. So this is the graphical representation. Okay, let's see, here we have two graphical problems. The first problem is an elevator is going up. Elevator is going up. The variation in the velocity of the elevator is given in the graph. Means variation of velocity is given in the graph. What is the height to which the elevator takes to the passenger? Means up to what height that is going. Up to what height that is going. So see here first, the elevator is starts from rest. Elevator is starts from rest. In 2 seconds its velocity is increases to 4 meter per second. In 2 seconds its velocity is increases to 4 meter per second. And after 8 seconds it is continuously moving with a constant velocity. And then velocity is decreases. And then velocity is decreases to 0. Now here up to what height that is going? Up to what height? What height is nothing but displacement. So we want to get the displacement. Displacement if you want to get assembly area of the graph. So first case, here a displacement S1 I am considering, here a displacement I am considering S2 and as well as S3. So first take S1. S1 is, it is in the form of triangle. Area of the triangle. Half into base 2 into height 4. Nothing but first 4 meters it is going with increasing velocity. After S2, after it is look like a rectangle. Rectangle is nothing but a length into breadth. Length 10 minus 2. 10 minus 2 into height breadth is nothing but 4. So that is nothing but 8. 8 fours are 32 meters. For 32 meters it's going with constant velocity and then decreasing velocity for 2 seconds. Again S3 is equal to half into base into height. So the value is again 4 meters. Now the total height taken, total height, first 4 meters, next 36 meters and next 32 meters and next 4 meters. Total 4 plus 32 plus 4, nothing but 40 meters, which is taken to the passengers to a height of 40 meters. Easy question. Simply, whenever if they are asking regarding displacement, you have to take the area of the graph only. And let's see the next question. What is that? Next question is here, VT graph given, velocity time graph given, and they are asking find the distance and as well as displacement in the 6th seconds. Distance and as well as a displacement. How that is going? First it is going with 4 meter per second positive velocity and then minus 4 meter, minus 2 meter per second for some time and then plus 2 meter per second some time. So means you need to get this area plus this area, means if you are taking this is as S1, S2 and as well as S3. Distance if you want to calculate, distance is nothing but S1 plus S2 plus S3, because distance is independent on direction. But displacement depends on direction. Displacement if you want to take, displacement is equal to S1 positive, S2 negative, S3 positive. That's all. So first you try to get the value of S1. S1 is area of this portion. Area of this portion. Time how much here given? This is your 2. And up to here 4. Up to here 6. 2 and this is 4. 2 fours are 2 into 4. 8. 8 meters. S1. S2. This is a 2 and this is 2. 2 2s are 4 meters. S3. 2. 2. 2 2s are 4. Yes. Now take the total distance. Distance 8 plus 4 plus 4. Distance 16 meters. Displacement 8 minus 4 plus 4. Minus 4 plus 4 cancel. So that is equal to 8 meters. Here it travels 16 meters of distance and 8 meters of displacement. So these are the problems on graphical representation. To get more problems, you have to practice properly the graphicals, then you can able to solve.